So last time we have covered the walls of abdomen and muscles of abdomen. Now we will cover the inguinal canal, formation of inguinal canal and process, mechanism also. Then, so we will start the inguinal canal. Inguinal canal. So first, what is the inguinal canal, where is present? So first we know, this is iliac bone. And here is pubic symphysis. And here is pubic tubercle, we know these terms. There is a ligament called, is a ligament present between, and this point is called anterior superior iliac span, and this is pubic tubercle. A ligament is present between these two points, anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle. This ligament is called inguinal ligament. This is called inguinal ligament. Then inguinal ligament. Then, this is a simple. This helps in formation of inguinal canal. What is inguinal canal? It is a canal-like structure. Canal tube, ya phir gutter type. Canal tube-like. Ya phir passage. Simple in passage. Canal-like structure. Formed by muscles and epimerosis of abdominal muscles, abdominal wall. Epimerosis, then of abdomen. Then it is present in lower side between abdomen and pelvic region, just like abdomen. Also present in this is, here is, it is also present in false pelvis, greater pelvis, we will cover next. Done? So these are the some points. Abdomen. Done? So let's take the section from superior to anterior, superior to internal. Done? First, we know outer side pin, here is outer leg. We know a muscle present, this muscle is called external oblique muscle. Below this, a muscle called internal oblique and another is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. Third muscle. And last, we know the fascia present below transverse abdominis called fascia transversalis. Fascia, simple fascia will be drawn from this. This is fascia transversalis. Done? These four things help in formation of inguinal canal. So first cover some points. There is a defect or hole present in facial transversalis and external oblique muscle. These are called rings. लिख देते हैं पॉइंट। हियर इज डिफेक्ट, सब इज डिफेक्ट प्रेजेंट इन डिफेक्ट प्रेजेंट इन फेशियल ट्रांसफर सेल्स। डिफेक्ट मीन्स अ होल, वेयर इज दिस फेशियल नॉट प्रेजेंट, सिंपल होल जस्ट। फेशियल ट्रांसफर सेल्स, ट्रांसफर सेल्स एंड एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक, नल ओब्लिक डन, दीज आर कॉल्ड रिंग्स। रिंग्स, रिंग्स मीन वी नो सुपरफिशियल एंड डीप मीनिंग, मीन सुपरफिशियल विच इज नियर टू स्किन, डीप मीन्स विच इज अवे फ्रॉम स्किन। सो फर्स्ट वी नो एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक इज सुपरफिशियल देन फेशियल ट्रांसफर सेल्स, सो हियर इज रिंग प्रेजेंट डेफिशिएंट पॉइंट। एंड हियर इज अनदर पॉइंट प्रेजेंट डेफिशिएंट पॉइंट, डिफेक्ट पॉइंट। दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर कॉल्ड रिंग्स, दिस इज सुपरफिशियल, सो सुपरफिशियल इनगुइनल रिंग एंड हियर इज डीप इनगुइनल रिंग। Superficial, wait, this is deep inguinal ring, deep inguinal ring which is present in facial transverse, which is also deep, deep inguinal ring, and this is called superficial inguinal ring. Done. Remember these two points. These are called gates of inguinal canal. Gates means entry and exit point where structures passes from this, passes from inside and outside canal, entry exit point. So this gate. Now take the section. Inguinal canal presents. Done. Inguinal canal starting from this, then defect in facial transverse, then it passes from this. Remember the internal oblique muscle and transverse abdominis has defect which is present above this, not taking much defect, this is present above. So inguinal ring present below from this. These form roofs of inguinal, you know, a canal form just like this. Let's say this is canal, just a pipe simple. So these pipe has roof, upper part, lower part, floor and walls outside. This is front wall, back side wall. So this is canal like structure. So some structure form roof, floor, anterior wall, posterior wall like that. So this canal present like this. Then It does not pierce these two things. It just passes below from this. Then, so let's see here. Here, what point will be? Inguinal canal. Inguinal canal. Do not pierce internal oblique and transverse abdominis. Done. these two structures not pierced by umbilical canal. These are present just below. Let's say this is canal. So these structure present above, like that. These not pierced by that. Here, just form the roof of the canal. Done. So this is inguinal canal. Now we know there are some points which form anterior and posterior wall, etc. So cover the walls of the inguinal canal. So first we know what we can see. These are the some points of the inguinal canal. Then we write. Just we see what we see. What we write. Then we write. Then so first here is, and this is part of anterior canal, anteriorly from this. This is present outside anteriorly. This is called external oblique, and fascia is present posteriorly. So we will write walls, anterior wall. Anterior wall. Wall. Anterior wall is formed by the external oblique muscle, first point. External oblique. Done. And remember important point here. We know laterally muscle. Laterally from here, this anterior superior iliac spine and iliac spine, we know some muscles are attached laterally 2/3 and laterally 1/3. So these also form anterior wall. We know the internal oblique muscle, these present anteriorly iliac spine pin, 2/3 of iliac spine, 2/3 iliac spine. We know this is, remember, this is the origin of internal oblique. 2/3 iliac spine, and it also take origin from some part of inguinal ligament also, and some inguinal ligament. Done. So remember these things. Let's say this is internal oblique. This is the internal oblique. So these are also form the wall of the anterior wall of the inguinal canal. So we will also including here. And internal, but laterally, this is present only laterally, not medially. Internal oblique. Done. Laterally. Because this is present only laterally. Remember, internal oblique muscle take origin from here and here and go above and towards linear alba. Then lateral clip. So from anterior side we see just like that, anteriorly. Let's say this is canal anteriorly, first present. This is external oblique muscle. Done. And laterally present internal oblique. Done. Anterior wall. Anterior, this is external oblique, this is internal oblique. Done. Finished. Anterior wall is finished. Now come to the posterior wall. Posterior wall has some important points. So this anterior wall, then posterior wall is done. पोस्टीरियर वॉल, एंटीरियर वॉल में एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक एंड इंटरनल ओब्लिक, इंटरनल ओब्लिक प्रेजेंट लेटरली लाइक दिस मीडियली, दिस मीडियल पॉइंट, दिस इज लेटरल, डन मीडियम लेटरल. So medially external oblique and laterally internal oblique. Then this anterior wall. How deep inguinal canal? So inguinal canal. These are the wall points. Now come to the posterior wall. Posterior wall is written. Posterior wall. Done. This is separate. Posterior wall. Posterior wall में include क्या करेंगे? We know the transverse abdominis and external oblique not present posteriorly. These present super above from above to inguinal canal. Not present posteriorly. Done. So this is not included. Now come to the another point. So only fascia present posteriorly is fascia transversalis. So posterior wall is formed by fascia transversalis first. Fascia transversalis. Done. First point. Now come to the another point. We said that transverse abdominis and internal oblique not present posteriorly, but these are not present like this. These present like this. The position of external oblique, the position of internal oblique and transversal abdominis. This. ये इसके ऊपर से निकल जाएगा, ये भी इसके ऊपर से निकलेगा, and after this, these form a solid tendon. The transverse abdominis and internal oblique combine and form a solid tendon posteriorly. This tendon is called conjoint tendon. Done? Conjoint tendon. Conjoint tendon. Important point. So through by throwing this. We know the conjoint tendon present posteriorly. We can see the conjoint tendon posteriorly. But in which side? Medial side. This is lateral side, this is medial side again. So, medially, conjoint tendon also present in posterior wall, which is combination of transverse abdominis and internal oblique. So, include conjoint tendon. Which part? Medially. Remember. Medially. Done. Which is also important. Now come to the another important aspect. Some part of inguinal ligament also reflect on posteriorly from in a post abdominal wall like this. Posteriorly it go to the linear nerve. This is present posteriorly. Posteriorly. This is a linear nerve. This is a linear nerve. This is some part, remnant part of inguinal ligament. This is what? Remnant of inguinal ligament. Ligament. Done. Ligament. Also are called reflected part. It's called reflected part of inguinal ligament. Then reflected part of inguinal ligament, which is also present. We know linear alba present medially, so this is also present in medially, but in posterior wall. So we include also this reflected part of inguinal ligament. Then, so these are the parts of posterior wall which form the posterior wall. Then, these are important points of posterior wall. Posterior wall formed by this. Then, and now anterior wall and posterior wall finished. Now come to the roof and floor of the inguinal canal. So first cover the floor. Floor of inguinal canal. Floor. Floor of inguinal canal is simply just formed by inguinal ligament. Inguinal ligament is present like this. Let's say come from above like this. In this is part of external oblique muscle, and it external oblique inferiorly it turns posteriorly and go like this. Some canal are formed. Like this, niche a canal form like gutter type. Then, like this. Laterally, in sagittal view, it look like this. Esternooblique muscle come and then turns like this. This is inguinal ligament. Inguinal ligament. So it present like this. So it form the floor of the inguinal canal. Then floor of the inguinal canal formed by inguinal ligament. Ligament. Then this is not much important. Much hard. Then this is simple floor. So anterior wall, posterior wall and floor. Finished. Now come to the roof. Roof is somewhat important. Now come to the wall, roof of inguinal canal. Roof. We know roof is formed by transverse abdominis and internal oblique muscle. So we can simply write, because it presents above the inguinal canal. It is not pierced by inguinal canal. The roof is formed by internal oblique, and transverse abdominis. These are the some points of inguinal canal. This is roof. Sometimes also include some part of external oblique, but it is not important. We can include external oblique also. Minor external oblique. You can't really leave this. This is not important. Then, so these are, this is the roof of the inguinal canal. External oblique and internal oblique. Then, roof, floor, anterior wall, posterior wall. These are the some walls of the inguinal canal. Now, take the sagittal section. In sagittal section, it is present like this. We draw, this is the external oblique muscle. External oblique and internal oblique. Internal oblique and transverse abdominis present like this. Let's say this is internal oblique muscle and this is transverse abdominis. they present like this. This is conjoint tendon. They remember medially they form the conjoint tendon. You can write. This is internal oblique. This is transverse abdominis. And this is conjoint tendon. Done. So this is sagittal view of canal. This is sagittal view of canal. This is inguinal canal. You can draw this flow like this. Done. This is canal. And posteriorly, the fascia present. This is called fascia transversalis. Fascia transversalis. Then fascia transversalis. Then this canal present like this. The sagittal view and superior view. Now come to the contents of the inguinal canal. Contents include contents. Remember one thing, all the structure which passes from the inguinal canal must pass from the deep inguinal canal, passes from this and come out from superficial inguinal canal. So these canal or these muscles or epiglottis form some fascia over the structures which passes from the this. Means some fascia are formed by this epiglottis which passes from the inguinal canals. Let's say like this. Let's say this is the deep inguinal ring. Let's say a ductus deferentia passes from here. Ductal deferentia in male. So when it passes, a fascia form above the ductus deferentia. Then this fascia formed by fascia transversalis, internal oblique muscle and external oblique. Three fascia formed by three structures. Remember, transverse abdominis form and no any fascia. Fascias formed by fascia transverse, that is internal oblique and external oblique. When structures passes from these, so a layer formed above the structure, just simple layer fascia. So first we write contents. Contents include in male ductus deferentia, simple spinal cord is there, spermatic cord also include many things, spermatic cord, first genital branch of genitofemoral nerve. This is a nerve which is present in lumbar plexus of genitofemoral nerve. Done. Just simply learn this content. Or we will learn later when you revise this structure, the whole study. Done. And ilioinguinal nerve, just simply note, and we will learn in later. In ilioinguinal nerve, some vessels, ductus artery, cremastric arteries, many things present here. This is content in male. This is male, for male. And what about female? In female, we include ilioinguinal nerve. This is common for both inguinal nerve. Genitofemoral nerve also common. But remember, no spermatic cord present in female. So genitofemoral nerve to femoral nerve, and the last structure which is most important is round ligament of uterus. Uterus ka round ligament, a ligament of uterus, not important, but this is most important structure in contents of inguinal canal in finger. So these are the contents of inguinal canal. Done. So you can note this first. Done. Now come to the contents of the spermatic cord and fascias formed by these three layers. Remember, fascia transversal is internal oblique and external oblique. So some fascia, first let's say this is the spermatic cord longitudinally. Then it has three fascias. This is the spermatic cord above it. It has three fascia. First, when it enters from deep inguinal ring. So first, it is formed by this fascia is called internal, which is formed by fascia transversalis. Internal spermatic fascia. Spermatic fascia. Done. Then it and inside inguinal canal, another fascia formed, present on both sides. Then another fascia formed inside the second layer is called cremastric fascia, which is formed by internal oblique muscle. This is internal spermatic fascia is formed by fascia transversalis. That is second fascia, cremastric fascia formed by internal oblique muscle. Done? Wait. This is spermatic cord, which contain ductus deferentia, testicular arteries and etc. This is duct, spermatic cord. These are the layers. First layer, internal oblique. You can draw the whole layer. Second layer is called spermatic fascia. Spermatic fascia. And third layer, which is formed by external oblique muscle, is called external spermatic fascia. Then, so these are the fascias formed by canals. This is formed by internal oblique. This is formed by fascia transversalis. This is formed by external oblique. Then, remember, all structures which pass from the inguinal canal have these structures. बट इंपॉर्टेंट नोट, रिमेंबर इलियम इंग्वाइनल नर्व, मैं पढ़ा था कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ इंग्वाइनल कैनाल, इलियम इंग्वाइनल नर्व, इलियम इंग्वाइनल नर्व नॉट एंटर इन डीप इंग्वाइनल रिंग, वी नो स्ट्रक्चर्स पास फ्रॉम डीप इंग्वाइनल रिंग passes from deep inguinal ring and come out through superficial inguinal ring through inguinal canal, not entering deep inguinal ring. Instead, enter through posterior wall. It pierces the posterior wall and come in inguinal canal through posterior wall of inguinal canal. Posterior wall and pass enter inguinal canal, enter in inguinal canal and then come out through superficial inguinal ring. So it is called partial content of inguinal canal. No, we know true content pass from inguinal canal, pass through internal inguinal ring and come out as superficial inguinal ring through that, but it is not enter from deep inguinal ring. So it is called partial content, not true content. True content pass from deep to superficial. Partial content of inguinal canal. Inguinal canal. Done. Now come to the contents of the spermatic cord. Done. We take a transverse section. First, fascias. Done. We draw fascias. If we write the contents of inguinal canal, we should have right to contents of the spermatic cord. And this is fascia again. Done. This is external spermatic fascia. External spermatic fascia. This is cremastric fascia. Cremastric fascia. And this is internal spermatic fascia. Done. Khatam. Now come to the contents. A wide duct present. This is whole. This is come both. This is completely filled with muscles. Done. Completely filled with muscles. Thick layer. काफी thick muscles होते हैं इसमें. Because to push the sperms. So it is called ductus differentia. Done. No hole present. Just simply ductus differentia. Completely filled. Okay. This is called ductus differentia. And another is called near the artery is called ductus artery. Above this artery is called testicular artery. And here is a plexus of veins present called pimpiniform plexus. Venous plexus near the artery, the pimpiniform plexus, and some part of some remnant of process vaginalis remnant. What is process vaginalis? Just it is a canal, it is a sub initiating part of the part which form the inguinal canal in future. Just a marking like this. Let's say a deepening starting from the fascia transversalis and come out through external opening like this. This is layers. Let's say this fascia transversalis, a deepening present starting in embryonic cell. Deepening start from the fascia transversalis and come open in fascia in external opening. This is called process vaginalis initially. Process vaginalis. Not much difficult, just an initial part of the initial stages of the inguinal canal, just deepening like this, starting from this and come open in the superficial inguinal, superficial inguinal ring. It's starting from the fascia transversus, open in external oblique, internal oblique, transverse abdominis, and fascia transversus. Done. Just a deepening like this. And structures also present. Some arteries also present here. Done. So naming kar dete hain. First is ductus differentium. Ductus differentium. This is called cremastric artery. Arteries, cremastric artery. This is called ductus artery. Ductus artery, ductus differentia artery. Simple ductus, ductal differentia in ear artery. This is remnant of process vaginalis. नीचे शो कर दिया मैंने. Malis. Done. This is tympaniform plexus of veins. Tympaniform plexus of veins. And this is testicular artery. Simple. Testicular artery. And these are the fascias. External axillomatic, internal axillomatic, transverse abdominis, in this external or in cremastic region. So these are the contents of the spermatic cord. This is spermatic cord, whole cord. Done. So note this. So here we finish the lecture. Next time we will cover the diaphragm, from and diaphragm important points, arteries, etc. Thank you.